Hello viewers, welcome back. I am Neha Paryani. So in today's session, we are going to discuss about fundamentals of partnership accounting from class 12. So let's start. Partners capital account. In my previous sessions, we have already discussed the basics of partnership accounting, its theoretical part, and we have also discussed what is profit and loss appropriation account and problems relating to it, right? So if you are new to my channel and if you have not watched the previous videos yet, their link will be provided in the description box below. You can check it out. So today we are going to discuss about the partner's capital account. Okay. So all the transactions relating to the partners of the firm are recorded in the books of the firm through partner's capital accounts. See, in order to record all the transactions that are relating to the partners and with the business, like the transactions which are carried on between the partners and the business, will be recorded in a separate account called partner's capital account. Okay. This includes the amount of money brought as capital, withdrawn of capital, share of profit, interest on capital, interest on drawings, partner's salary, commission to partners, etc. So all these things will be recorded in the partner's capital account. Okay. So there are two methods of preparing partner's capital account. They are fixed capital method and fluctuating capital method. Okay. So in this session, we are going to learn both of these topics, both of these methods, and we are also going to solve one problem regarding these. Okay. So the first method of preparing partner's capital account is fixed capital method. So again, in the fixed capital method, two accounts will be prepared. So we name them as partner's capital account and partner's current account. Okay. So in partner's capital account, only the entry relating to the partner's capital will be shown. Okay. See, the capital that is initially invested by the partner, or the capital that is later, or the additional capital that is invested by the partner, only these two entries will be shown in the partner's capital account. Okay. Any other entry other than capital will not be shown in this type of account, right? Next, partner's current account. All the items like profit or loss, interest on capital, drawings, interest on drawings, etc. So, all the other transactions other than capital will be shown in the partner's current account. Okay, so because these will be keep on changing, right? So but the capital will be fixed until and unless the additional capital is invested by the partner. Okay, so that's why we name it as partner's current account, because these things can keep changing, right? So I hope you're clear now. In fixed capital method, we again prepare two accounts, that is partner's capital account and current account. So in capital account, we make the entry of capital only, and in current account, other than capital, all the entries will be made in the partner's current account. Okay. So now let's have a look at the format of the partner's fixed capital account. Okay. So first is partner's capital account format. Okay. So as I told you, only the entries relating to the capital are shown. So that will be shown on the credit side of this account. Right. So this is the format. Debit and credit side, we have date column, particulars, general folio, amount. And again on credit side, we have date column, particulars, general folio and amount. Okay. So the capital that is invested by the partner will be shown on the credit side. First is initial capital or opening capital, and then additional capital. If in case we have additional capital, we need to show it here. Right. So now we will total both the amount. Then we'll get certain amount here, right? So that same amount should be written on the debit side as the closing balance, or you can also call it as the balancing figure, right? So only this much has to be shown in the partner's capital account, right? Now the format of partner's current account. So again, we have on debit side, we have date column, particulars, general folio and amount. On credit side, we have date, particulars, general folio and amount, right? So now here we need to remember that whatever is beneficial for the partner will be shown on the credit side. Okay. And whatever is either an expense or loss to the partner will be shown on the debit side. Right. So this is a very important point that you need to remember. See, balance brought down, if there is credit balance, we show it on the credit side. If there is debit balance, we show it on the debit side. Okay. Then by interest on capital, see here the partner is going to get the interest on capital, right? from the firm. So it is beneficial for the partner, so we are showing it on the credit side, right? Next, partner is also going to get salary or commission, so we show it on the credit side. And profit or loss from profit or loss appropriation account. See, before preparing the capital accounts of the partner, we prepare profit and loss appropriation account, right? So if in case in that there is the distribution of profit to the partner, so that profit will be shown on the credit side. So profit is beneficial to the partner, so we are showing it on the credit side, right? Now let's come on the debit side. So drawings. See, when the partner makes the drawings, the partner has to pay back that amount to the business. So it is kind of expense for the partner, right? So drawings will be shown on the debit side. Next, interest on drawings. So along with the drawings, the partner also has to pay interest on the drawings, right? So again, it is an expense to the partner, so on debit side. Next. So as I told you, when there is profit from the profit and loss appropriation account, we show it on the credit side, right? And if in case there is a loss from profit and loss appropriation account, we show it on the debit side. Clear? So after making all the entries, now we will total both the amount columns again. So assume that there is more amount on the credit side, right? So when we total that and when we deduct all these expenses from this amount, we get a balancing figure, so that we can call it as by to balance carried down, right? So this is the format of the partner's current account. Okay, next, moving on to fluctuating capital method. So this is the second method of preparing partner's capital accounts, right? So under the fluctuating method, only one account, that is capital account, is maintained for each partner. See, in the fixed capital method, we have prepared two accounts, right? But in fluctuating capital method, we are going to prepare only one account, right? So all the adjustments like capital, interest on drawings, profit or loss, everything will be shown in this single account, right? So when we see the format, so if you look carefully, the fluctuating capital account is the combination of partner's capital account and partner's current account, right? So when we combine both of these accounts, we get the format of fluctuating capital account. Okay, again, the what is beneficial for the partner will be shown on the credit side, and the expenses or losses will be shown on the debit side. So again, we record the opening capital, then additional capital, the salaries that the partners are getting from the firm, interest that the partner is getting, profit from the profit and loss appropriation account. Okay, next, on debit side, again we have drawings that the partner has made, interest on drawings that the partner has to pay to the firm. So if in case there is loss from P&L appropriation account, we show it on the debit side, right? So the format is simple, but it is just the combination of both of the accounts. Okay, so I hope you're clear up to now. Now let's try to solve a problem, then the whole concept will be clear to you. Okay, Samir and Yasmin are partners with capital of rupees 15 lakh and rupees 10 lakh respectively. So the initial capital has been given, that is 15 lakh for Samir and rupees 10 lakh for Yasmin, right? They agreed to share profits in the ratio of 3:2. Okay, show how following transactions will be recorded in the capital account of the partners in case the capitals are fixed, the capitals are fluctuating. So here we need to prepare both the type of accounts, right? So here the transactions have been given. We have to record this in the capital accounts of the partner. So we can once read them, right? Additional capital contributed on July 1, 2016. See, our books are closed on March 31st every year, means our year starts from 1st of April, right? And on 1st July, additional capital was contributed or invested. So this is the initial capital and this becomes the additional capital. Okay, then interest on capital that the partners have to receive from the firm is 5% of the capital, right? Of the total capital. Remember, not only initial capital, but 5% of total capital. Okay, so drawings during 2016. So drawings that the partners have made during the year are ₹30,000 and ₹20,000. And interest on drawings is directly given. We don't have to calculate it. Okay, so the amount is directly given in the question. Next, salaries that the partners are going to get are ₹20,000. Only Samir is going to get the salary. Yasmin is not going to get any salary. Okay, then commission. Samir is going to get commission of ₹10,000 and Yasmin ₹7,000. Okay, share in loss. Remember, there is a loss from profit and loss appropriation account. So we have to show this on the debit side. We'll see it later. Okay, but remember, this is a loss. This is not a profit. Okay, so the loss of ₹60,000 and ₹40,000. Okay, so one by one we can go on preparing the accounts. We'll start with the fixed method. Okay, so in fixed method we prepare two accounts, right? So in the capital account we will make the entry of only capital. Okay, so date we can write it as 1st of April, right? Initial capital was introduced on 1st of April, so here we can write it as balance, that is brought down. Samir ₹15 lakh and Yasmin ₹10 lakh. Okay, next, on 1st of July, we have the additional capital, right? So, mention the date and you can write it as by bank. Additional capital. Samir's additional capital is of ₹3 lakh and Yasmin's additional capital is of ₹2 lakhs. Okay, so we know that only these two transactions will be shown in the partner's capital account, right? Now we can total both the amounts. So here the total will be ₹18 lakh and here the total will be ₹12 lakhs. And on this side we have to write the same amount. So date is 31st of March, because we are closing the accounts now. On the year end we have to carry down this balance. Okay, so balance carried down ₹18 lakhs and ₹12 lakhs. So we can close the account now. Write the same amount here, 18 lakhs and ₹12 lakhs. So this is how we prepared the partner's capital account in the fixed capital method, right? Now moving on to next, we are going to prepare partner's current account, right? So now let's come back to the question. So this is recorded, additional capital is recorded. Now we have to record interest on drawings, right? So for calculating the interest on drawings, we need to show a working note, because we have to get the interest on total capital, not only initial, right? So we can show it as a working note. So for Samir, we can write it as calculation of interest on capital. Okay, so for Samir, his initial capital was ₹15 lakhs and 5% on that, right? So 5% of 15 lakhs would be ₹75,000. Okay, plus additional capital is ₹3 lakhs, right? And 5% on that. And then we have to remember the date here. So the additional capital was introduced on 1st of July. So from 1st of July to 31st March, it's only 9 months, right? So we need to get the interest. The firm will pay us the interest only for 9 months. It will not pay for full year, right? So here 9 divided by 12. We are going to get the interest for 9 months out of 12 months, right? So here our amount will be ₹11,250. Okay, so now the total of both of these will be the interest of capital. So the amount is ₹86,250. Okay, are you clear now? Next, for Yasmin, right? So his initial capital is ₹10 lakhs and 5% on 10 lakhs is ₹50,000. Right, plus his additional capital is ₹2 lakhs and 5% of that, and for 9 months. So 9 divided by 12, So here the amount will be rupees 7,500. So the total of this will be 57,500. Now this is the interest on capital for Samir and this is for Yasmin. Okay. So now we have to record this in the account, in the current account. So we can write it as interest on 31st of March, because we are going to get the interest on at the year ending, right? So interest on capital Samir rupees 86,250 and Yasmin rupees 57,500. Okay, now interest on capital is done. Now drawings during 2016. See, drawings will be recorded on the debit side, right? So record it. Drawings. Here the particular date has not been mentioned, so we can leave it as blank. Okay. So drawings. Rupees 30,000 and rupees 20,000. Okay. So 30,000 and 20,000. Now again interest on drawings. Rupees 1800 and 1200. So these are the expenses, so we have to record on the debit side. Interest on drawings. Here it's 31st March. All the interest will be received or given at the year ending itself. Okay, so it's 1800 and 1200. Next, salary. The partner is going to get the salary, so it is benefit for the partner, hence record it on the credit side. Rupees 20,000 only in the case of Samir, because Samir is going to get the salary. Yasmin is not going to get any salary. So salary to Samir rupees 20,000, and here we can leave it as nil. Okay, next is commission. Now both the partners are going to get the commission, that is rupees 10,000 for Samir and 7,000 for Yasmin. Again, commission is the benefit, so on credit side 10,000 and 7,000. Okay, next we have share in loss. So loss we have to show it on the debit side, right? Rupees 60,000 and rupees 40,000. So on 31st of March, remember, this is the loss from the profit and loss appropriation that we have prepared before the capital accounts. Okay, so we can mention it as share in loss. Rupees 60,000 and rupees 40,000. Okay, now we can total both the amount columns on both the sides. So the total of Samir's amount column is rupees 1,16,250 and total of Yasmin's amount column is rupees 64,500. Okay, so when we deduct all these expenses out of this amount, we get the balancing figure of rupees 24,450 and rupees 3,300. Okay, clear? So now we have prepared both the accounts from the fixed capital method, right? Now moving on to next, we have fluctuating capital method, right? So in this account I have just recorded all the entries here. So they are again they are same. Here what we have to do is we have to make combination of both the accounts, right? So first we have mentioned the capital, that is initial capital of both the partners, then the additional capital. Right, next we have to we are getting interest on capital, we are getting salary and commission. So just mention the same amounts here. Then on debit side, drawings and interest on drawings, and because there is share of loss in this problem, we are showing it on the debit side, right? Now we are going to total both the amount columns on both the sides, and again here in this case also we are getting more amount on credit side. So the total of Samir's amount column is rupees 19,16,250 and the total of Yasmin's column is rupees 12,64,500. Okay, now when we deduct all these expenses from this amount, we will get the balancing figure of rupees here on this side 18,24,450 rupees, and here 12,03,300 rupees. Okay, So is that clear? Now we can write it as on 31st March as balance carried down. Clear? Now we are going to close the account by writing the same amount here. 19,16,250 and ₹12,64,500. Okay, so generally we will make one single account, that is fluctuating capital method we will follow in the future coming problems. Okay, so I hope you're clear now. Okay guys, so this was all about today. If you found this helpful, please hit the like button, and for more such videos please subscribe to my channel. Hope to see you in my next videos. Till that, happy learning.